Yes, good morning everyone. So we are continuing with the chapter Fair Play. So till now we read that it is a story of two friends, Jumman and Algu, where they are just stuck in a tight spot. And how did they overcome this confusion? We were reading about that. There was one case regarding Jumman just due to his chachi, where Chachi filed a case against her nephew and the panchayat was held under the tree and Algu was nominated as head panch, but he just gave the fair decision in spite of his friendship with Jumman, right? So now it is the case of Algu, where he sold his bullocks to Samju Sahu and the bullock got died, and Samju Sahu was not ready to pay the price of the bullock, whereas Algu had no fault in this. Now he brought that case to panchayat. Now let's read further. So we are to start with 11th paragraph. So it says, Algu decided to refer the case to the panchayat. For a second time in a few months, preparations for holding the panchayat were made. So after a few months, this case was brought to the panchayat. So the preparations were being done to hold the panchayat. And both the parties started meeting people seeking their support. As I earlier told you, whenever a case is filed in panchayat, both the parties try to seek the support of the villagers, of the people, so that the verdict comes in their favor. Now, the panchayat was held under the old banyan tree, the same old banyan tree where the first panchayat was held. Algu stood up and said, the voice of the panch is the voice of God. The same ki jo panch ki awaz hoti hai, wo bhagwan ki awaz hoti hai. Let Sahu nominate the head panch. Now the opportunity was with Samchu Sahu that he should nominate the head panch. I will abide by his decision. Abide by means accept. We read this word yesterday also. So I will accept his decision. Sahu saw his chance. Chance means now he just saw the opportunity, because in front of him, before him, his best friend was there. That was Jumman. So usko to ye mauka mil gaya ki wo uska naam le and proposed the name of Jumman. So he suggested the name of Jumman as head punch. Algu's heart sank. Here, heart sank means nervous. He became nervous. Algu became nervous. Beta, note down the meanings of all the words that I'm telling you. You must write all the meanings of the words. Okay? Otherwise, if you don't know any other word, you can always refer to a dictionary. That is very much important for you to refer to dictionary, or you can surf Google also. Nowadays, everything is online. So side by side, you can also see the meanings on Google also. Algu became nervous and he turned pale. Pale means uska rang peela pad gaya, means he lost his color. Jab hame dar hota hai, to hamara rang jo hai, wo ud jata hai, peela pad jata hai. But what could he do? Okay, why did Algu become nervous? Just because he gave his verdict in the first case in favor of Jumman's chachi. Whereas Jumman was his best friend and Jumman was expecting that the verdict will come in his favor. But what happened? It happened exactly opposite to that. Algu gave his decision in favor of his chachi. Because at that time he was the head punch. There was no friendship and no enmity before him. A punch sees no friend and no enemy. So that is why he just took the fair decision, right? So the moment Jumman became head punch, he realized his responsibility. Now, when Algu was the head punch, Jumman could not realize his position. But now, when he himself became the head panch, he just understood his duty as judge and the dignity of his office. Dignity means honorable position. Dignity means honorable position. Office, office. Here, office means post. उसको अपनी पोस्ट की डिग्निटी का एहसास हुआ. जिस पोस्ट पे आप होते हो उसके लिए आपको लॉयल होना बहुत जरूरी है. उसके लिए आपको फेयर होना बहुत जरूरी है. नाउ व्हेन ही हिमसेल्फ बिकेम द जज, तब उसको पता चला कि जज की या हेड पंच की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी क्या होती है. ही कैन नॉट गिव एन इम्प्रॉपर डिसीजन. He cannot give an unfair decision. He has to be just. Usko just means usko just hona hi padega. Usko fair justice karna hi padega. Could he, seated in that high place, have his revenge now? Now, what were the thoughts coming into his mind? Wo soch raha tha ki itne uche position pe baith ke. Uche position means head panch sabse uche position hai us time pe. इतनी ऊंची पोजीशन पे बैठ के क्या वो अब अपने रिवेंज के बारे में सोच सकता है? नो, नेवर. ही थॉट एंड थॉट. ही केप्ट ऑन थिंकिंग. नो, ही मस्ट नॉट. नो, ही मस्ट नॉट अलाउ हिज पर्सनल फीलिंग्स टू कम इन द वे ऑफ स्पीकिंग द ट्रुथ एंड डूइंग जस्टिस. सो व्हेन ही थॉट ऑन दिस इशू, he just came out with the thought ki ab ye time nahi hai ki wo apni personal feelings ko samne leke aaye. Jo uske man mein grudges hain, jo uske man mein revenge lene ki bhavna hai, he cannot come those feelings in the way of speaking the truth. Wo sach bolne mein aur justice karne mein us badle ki bhavna ko nahi la sakta. Okay, because this is the dignity of his position. If he does so, he will be considered as an unfair judge. ठीक है ना? So both Algu and Sahu stated their cases. Stated means narrated, बताना. दोनों ने, Algu ने और Sahu ने अपने अपने केस बताए. They were cross-examined. I already told you the meaning of cross-examine. Cross means the opposite side. Opposite parties ने एक दूसरे से questioning की और बहुत questioning की. Whenever a case is brought to a court, आपने देखा भी होगा TV में या वैसे कि वो खड़े होते हैं और जो वकील होते हैं, the lawyers, they just ask questions to the opposite parties. पूछते हैं ना, so that is known as cross-examining. And the case was considered deeply. और उसको बहुत deeply देखा गया. Then Jumman stood up and announced. Now Jumman is the head punch, so he just stood up and he gave his verdict. It is our opinion that Sahu should pay Algu the price of the bullock. कि ये हम सबका मानना है कि Sahu को उस बैल का जो price है, उसकी जो कीमत है, वो अलगू को पे कर देनी चाहिए. When Sahu bought the bullock, because when he bought this bullock, it suffered from no disability or disease. इसको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं थी, कोई बीमारी नहीं थी, इसमें कोई भी डिसेबिलिटी नहीं थी. The bullock, the death of the bullock was unfortunate. Unfortunate means दुर्भाग्यपूर्ण. I mean, it was not in his favor, but Algu cannot be blamed for it. When did the bullock die? When it went to Samchu Sahu. And when Algu sold that bullock, it was facing no disability or no problem. Right? So Algu cannot be blamed for that. Algu could not contain his feelings. Could not contain means keep under control. He could not keep his feelings under control क्योंकि वो बहुत खुश हो गया था. He was overwhelmed with joy because Jumman gave his verdict in Algu's favor. So he just could not control his feelings. He just stood up and said loudly over and over again. वो खड़ा हुआ और बार बार कहने लगा, Victory to the panchayat. This is justice. God lives in the voice of the panch. कि पंचायत की जय हो, यही जस्टिस है. भगवान पंच की आवाज में रहते हैं. मीन्स कि जो भगवान है वो पंच के दिल में बसते हैं. सो ही वॉज वेरी मच हैप्पी ओवर दिस वर्डिक्ट. सो सून आफ्टर जुम्मन केम टू अलगू. वो जल्दी ही अलगू के पास आया. एम्ब्रेस्ड हिम. एम्ब्रेस्ड हिम मीन्स हग्ड हिम. उसको गले लगाया. जुम्मन खुद चल के अलगू के पास आया और उसको गले लगाया. एंड सेट सिंस द लास्ट पंचायत आई हैड बिकम योर एनिमी. डू यू रिमेम्बर द लास्ट पंचायत व्हेन अलगू गेव हिज वर्डिक्ट इन फेवर ऑफ चाची एंड ही जस्ट फॉरगॉट हिज फ्रेंडशिप विद जुम्मन. तो उस पंचायत के बाद मैं तुम्हारा दुश्मन बन गया था. टुडे आई रियलाइज्ड व्हाट इट मेंट टू बी अ पंच. बट आज मैंने रियलाइज किया है कि व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सिटिंग एट अ पोजीशन ऑफ अ हेड पंच. अ पंच हैज नो फ्रेंड नॉर एनिमी. एक पंच के लिए कोई दोस्त नहीं, कोई दुश्मन नहीं. ही नोज ओनली जस्टिस. उसको सिर्फ जस्टिस करना आना चाहिए. लेट नो वन डेविएट फ्रॉम द पाथ ऑफ जस्टिस. Now see the meaning that is given in the right side of your chapter. Deviate means move away from. Means कि किसी को भी अपने justice के रास्ते से दूर नहीं हटना चाहिए. Okay? किसी को भी अपने justice के path से deviate नहीं होना चाहिए. The one should never leave the path of justice and truth for friendship or enmity. अपनी दुश्मनी या दोस्ती के लिए, चाहे दुश्मनी हो चाहे दोस्ती हो, उस चीज के लिए यू शुड नेवर लीव द पाथ ऑफ जस्टिस एंड ट्रुथ. कभी भी न्याय और सच्चाई के लिए अपने मार्ग से दूर नहीं हटना चाहिए. सो अलगू एम्ब्रेस्ड हिज फ्रेंड एंड वेप्ट. अलगू ऑल्सो एम्ब्रेस्ड हिज फ्रेंड एंड दे बोथ स्टार्टेड क्राइंग एंड हिज टीयर्स वॉश्ड अवे ऑल द डर्ट of misunderstanding between them. और जो उनके आंसू थे उन आंसुओं ने सारा जो मैल था misunderstanding का दोनों के बीच में वो सारा धो दिया. All the dirt of misunderstanding that they were keeping in their hearts that was washed away with the tears. Right? So this is the story written by Premchand and he has been a very famous writer, especially for short stories. Okay, so I hope you must have enjoyed the chapter and really it is an interesting chapter. Now we will just discuss the question answers that are given in the back exercise. Okay, so that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed reading the chapter, you enjoyed listening to the chapter. So we'll meet tomorrow. Till then, bye.